It was Friday, June 15th, 12:34 p.m. It was just another day in the office of CSI, crime-sniffing investigators. I was hard at work when suddenly I heard footsteps in the hallway. And in through my dog door crawled a kid. A sad kid. Nah, kid should be happy and skipping and frolicking. It broke my heart. What's the matter, kiddo?
I was reading a joke book, but I wasn't laughing.
It wasn't Jay Leno's joke book, was it?
No. Something must be wrong with me. I can feel it in my bones.
Well, I'm no doctor, but I can sniff out clues. So I gave him the once-over. And that's when it hit me. His funny bone was missing. I told him not to panic. I'd take the case. You need a funny bone to survive these days. Figured I'd better dust him for fingerprints. I didn't have any dust, so I used a powdered donut. I polished off the donuts and dusted him good, but I didn't find any fingerprints. But I did find lots of nose prints. Bingo. A clue. A dog must have taken his funny bone. I told him to retrace his footsteps to think when he last had it. He said he remembered having it when he was on the playground this morning. But he also remembered a little yippy dog sniffing at it too. A suspect. Come on, kid. Let's go. We can catch a clue with the King County Library. I found a book on little yippy dogs in the 636.7 section. That's him, all right. Yep, yippy dogs dislike funny bones because everybody's always laughing at them. There's a motive. So we went back to the scene and I followed the yippy dog paw prints. Finally, I came to the yippy dog's doggy door. I rang the bell. His human answered. I need to speak to your yippy dog, ma'am. He's a suspect in a missing bone case.
Oh, he couldn't have done it, detective.
Why not?
Well, look at him. He went to the vet this morning and has to wear that lampshade thing.
That was the funniest thing I'd seen all day. But the kid didn't even break a smile. He just sighed. Well, that yippy dog couldn't have carried off a bone, so I had to dig deeper. Did you see any other dogs today?
Oh, yeah. When I was riding my bike down an alley, I remember a big dog was barking at me.
Hey, you kid! Get off my lawn!
Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
Hey! Hey! You! You! You!
Bingo! Another suspect. We went to the big old dog's house. But when I saw all those beware of dog signs and a great big dog door, well, I got nervous. So we ran back to the library to catch a clue. I figured I'd better bone up on my commands. I checked out a book on obedience training in the 636 section. It says if you're gonna talk to a big dog, you better be firm. We went back to the big dog's house and peeked in. Suddenly, the dog door burst open. That big dog was running towards us in a flash. I remembered the obedience book and I yelled, "Sit, stay."
Okay.
I said, "Good boy, Cujo. I just want to ask you some questions, see? Do you remember this kid?"
Huh? No.
Well, he rode by here today. Maybe you'd remember his funny bone, huh? Do you remember taking that, huh? Do you remember, huh?
No, I don't remember nothing, huh?
Well, maybe you'd remember for a Scooby snack?
A treat? Oh boy, I love those. Wait a minute, I'm not allowed to have any hard treats. I have no teeth. I gotta wear doggy dentures.
Huh?
Oh man, I dropped them again. Where'd they go this time, dang nabbit?
They're over there, stuck on that chew toy by the tree. That was the second funniest thing I'd seen today, but the kid just yawned. I was back to square one. That old dog with no teeth couldn't have taken the funny bone. I thought long and hard. Doggy, doggy, where's that bone? Think, think, think. The boy must not be telling me everything. What do kids do during these summer days? Wait a minute. The joke book. Whoa. That's a library Whoa. Book. Whoa. Of course. The library. We ran in slow motion for dramatic effect back to the library. Well, the summer reading program had just started today. It was June 15th. You can sign up at your local King County Library or online at kcls.org. Kids that read for 500 minutes get a coupon for personal pan pizza at Pizza Hut starting July 16th. Oh! Kids that read for 1,000 minutes get a finisher prize, their very own casebook. There's fun entertainment at the library this summer, too.
You can be a backyard detective.
There's musicians.
How many animals do you see? Look down on the ground, up in the sky.
Jugglers.
Under a rock or out in a tree. Can you find a squirrel? You can be a backyard detective.
Science.
How many animals do you see? Look down on the ground, up in the sky. Under a rock or out in a tree. Can you find two cats?
And fun performers.
You can be a backyard detective. How many animals do you see?
If kids finish reading by August 31st, they'll be entered into a drawing to win one of three brand new laptop computers.
Wow!
The drawing is September 10th. Everyone comes to the library for fun. Look, there's Ashley Robinson from the Seattle Storm.
Oh, hi!
Hey, how's it going? So I set up a crime scene down the 398 section where the joke books are. I figured that's where the kid last had his funny bone. I sniffed around looking for clues everywhere. Then a friendly, helpful, and courteous librarian brought over a box that said lost and found. If it was going to be anywhere, it was going to be in there. And guess what? It was. The kid must have dropped his funny bone there. He was glad to have his sense of humor back. Then I found my favorite book of all time, Go Dog Go. Go dog, go dog, go dog go. Another mystery solved by Sherlock Hounds, CSI. Oh, wait a minute. Where's my library card? Let it go.